need to develop this mine, so yeah, basically. And convert all this stuff all over again. Correctly, you are gonna have a rebellion here. Guys are happy enough, so this is gonna go fast. We won't have enough points to develop the gold mine. Edicts to speed up this conversion. That's gonna guarantee a couple of rebellions. But I need the manpower and I need the money. Gonna make sure these fires, all 14 of them, in provinces with 13 supply limit. The army. Everyone goes there, whatever. They can take forever and one day to spawn. sort of this, the randomness in this game is so huge. I've said it several times that there's no point strategizing. I mean, no matter how much strategy you put into these, you can still be screwed by the random number generator. This is why I don't like luck-based events, and this is a luck-based achievement, and this is one of them. No matter how well I play, I'm in the hands of the random number generator. Now imagine trying to do this at very hard. Anyway. I'm afraid I'm gonna boost the stability. If I boost the stability to 0, these dudes don't spawn right away. If I'm lucky, I might ditch this rebellion. You know where rebels will spawn. It's in the highest development, almost always. When you're small, that stack, the stack might be divided in two, but instead of one big stack, you'll have two stacks. That's harder to guess where they'll spawn, but if it's just one stack, say like 99% of the times they spawn on the highest development. So we just see, take a look at the provinces are contributing to the faction and see which of them has the highest development. That's where they'll spawn. For this one, give it to the clergy. But it should go much faster than what the game is saying. That 27 months. Sure. Don't tell me that I didn't. Yeah. That's why. that's what happened. Let's use the one diplomat to improve relations with outraged countries. Since we know better, let's mark everyone around our allies with saying we love them. But we are not called into their stupid wars. Take forever. Troops over there. More than 22 points. So I wanna not only develop this because of the money, I also want to spawn the Renaissance. I mean, I want to embrace it, not spawn it. Again, a poor event, another one. You're already in a very shitty position. The game just pushes you. Shoot you down even further. And it still pays off to push to click this button. We have lots of local autonomy. We have war exhaustion. Yes, we still have war exhaustion. I'm gonna wait to record this. The rebels won't actually spawn, but oh, completely forgot, I need to guys help. We developed that mine. 25% if I recruit a minister, it's gonna go to... Which helps offset some of these penalties. For national unrest, plus 2 event in a row. Rebels won't spawn. I said the rebels won't spawn. I don't think they'll spawn. Well, they actually might. Yeah, because of the plus 4 from negative stability. Was far from negative stability and that event. They spawn, they spawn. Still the peasants war. I'm gonna do this slightly different this time around. I'm gonna go for the tech first, then core stuff after that. I'm gonna go for the techs. This stuff all has a shit ton of local autonomy, so much. The thing is, giving this to the clergy, I can speed up the conversions. waiting for these guys to spawn or to go away. August of next year. Ship durability. This is so fucked up. I don't have a single ship. How come this guy can be a navigator? Okay, let's wait for the event that kills this air. I'm gonna go for the tech after I lock Renaissance. The reason why I'm doing it is because I need money to not go bankrupt. The Renaissance is gonna stacking up in military cheaper. Dreadful terrain, mountains. If I don't do this, so expensive. Paying extra 3 ducats every month waiting for this to spawn. In a 3 development province, I might as well push this button. I would never recover the money that I'm spending here. Game is malfunctioning, it's giving me a good event. Oh shoot, I just lost the theologian. Let's remove this. In wait, not only not even a fucking month this event spawned. Like clockwork. Well, you know what this means? This means that I'm gonna have to remove everything from the clergy. Waiting. Any loans? Yes. I get worse before it becomes better. Okay, let's make some stage. Reason it's because I don't need this admin for anything else. But I'm not about to cap either, so. Going. In the first playthrough, the one that I just finished, I went through the trouble of managing everything. If you just joined the stream, you're probably wondering why I don't give a fuck about the edicts and etc etc. I just wanna get this over with. It won't make a huge difference. I've micromanaged this in the other run. They have to come over here or over. Let's just go say hello. Hello rebels, how are you doing? Apparently they're better now. If you're wondering why I'm not boosting stability, it's because of these. It will go away eventually. One bad event after the other.
Time.
I go with more karma, I'll lose ducats. Lots of them. But minus 100 anyway, with what I'm about to do, so... Stop. To make states. Much money. Everything from the clergy. I'm paying for the state maintenance, but I'm not seeing the money. That's what's going on here. All thanks to a bloody event. I give this to the nobles, to these dudes, what's gonna happen is that I'm gonna be hit with the social mobility event. Whatever, game. I'm gonna have to choose this one. I'm gonna put them at over 70 influence, so this means I can be hit with a social mobility event that will wreck everything. And minus 20 opinion for every. For every faction, with the exception of the merchants. Oops, I still have the peasants war thingy. Damn it. Damn it, forgot about it. Okay, this is not my day. I'm Not my day. Okay, let's bump the army maintenance. There's their supply limit for everyone. This is insane. All because, like I said, because of a fucking event that forced me to remove the provinces from the clergy. Let him spawn. Be at full maintenance. Annoying. It's just allied dive yet. I'm tired. The other campaign, I have decreased the local autonomy. I forgot to do it here. Whatever. Excuse me. Player does not want to help me. What a joke. Less for the loans. Good, because you're about to take more. Thousand 19 28,000 against my 3,000 and a shit ton of level 2 forts. Final, to say the least. Get the advisor. Oh, they changed their minds. That's good, because I was gonna do it anyway. I get there in time. Another shitty event. Sure they don't screw me with the part of the provinces. Sweet, sweet, sweet. More inflation, less inflation, who cares? Yeah, that's suicidal. Whatever. Stop to understand the reasoning behind this sort of thing. Even any reasoning. Speed 5 again. We are gonna grab this. After we grab it, we'll instantly prioritize military. Keep pressuring cruise control. You won't achieve anything, but you can keep doing, you can keep asking. I think I already said it. When I have a better microphone, I'll probably do it. To have a better microphone, I need to have a job that pays the bills. Lets me buy the said microphone, or you can donate and actually buy me a better microphone, but more than likely that money is gonna go towards paying the bills, because that has more importance. No face cam for quite some time. Again, the game lying to me, was saying that regiment would arrive at the same time as these dudes, and always arrives the day before. Always. It wasn't for the donations, I wouldn't be streaming here today. Wouldn't have money to pay the internet bill. I can also play at speed 5, I play very shitty, but I can also play at speed 5. As you're seeing, so 44 overextension. Can we handle these? Nope. Or we can't. Of course, I'm gonna face Ming in less than optimal. I'm in a much worse shape than the, in the previous game, because I wanna have more depth. Maybe the rolls won't be as bad. And 62. That's just what I needed, extra local autonomy. That or lose karma, gain unrest. Let's go with the rebels. Game is, it's rebels. Wouldn't be playing this if it wasn't for the rebels, they're so cute. Ooh, that's bad. Wait for the fort. Dudes are about to spawn here. We have a fort there, let's wait for the rebels to actually spawn. ally. Langshang. My ally. They've declared this war. We're ending this one. Unlike before, I'm gonna use the local autonomy here. I don't have patience to deal with rebels, and I don't think it's gonna make any difference. I mean, it might, but I don't care. Because what screwed me over in the last run were the rolls. We just need to be lucky, and that fixes everything. You don't need to use strategy, you don't need to actually play well, you just need good rolls. Being lucky. I still need to move the capital. Need to move the capital, and I still need 100 points to grab that. I need 1400 points. Military points. Making 4. 8. The needed points. So let's prioritize these right now. Grab the points, but we'll struggle to move the capital. Everything. The air. Yes, come of range. Yes, come of range. Let's see if you're lucky. Nope. Nope. Just garbage. This fort. Interestingly enough, all these guys spawned sooner than those that were supposed to spawn like ages ago. Stuck on top of this fort, that would be dreadful. Now, this is jungle. Oh. Nothing. Or not. Next is Ming. So we need to repay the loans, build forts, build an army, recover the manpower, that stuff. Or die again. Game, could you please give me a break? With regard to military, you're making money. Yay. Okay, let's build a spy network on Ming. Are so good. They didn't build a fort here. Near my border, I don't know why. Wait, a little bit. Taking my military points, that's probably what happened last time, and screwed me. I didn't pay attention to it. Like clockwork. Then let's wait for the game to kill my heir. I don't care. Just like last time. Economic buildings early, then make a merc army later. I cannot afford that. Thanks for the suggestion, anyway. Each worth like 100 ducats. 100 ducats to be repaid takes forever. Actually, I mean, we need 117 shitty provinces. Nation, what I'm that. Buildings correctly. We're more expensive in city terrain, but I had inflation in this run. It's easy. We need divide that by 100. Divide 100 by 1.2. Like 500 months or so. Yes, we need 500 months to actually recover the money that we spent, like 41 years. That's basically very bad in a playthrough like this. But we only have 56 years. Defensive ideas. The reason why I went for the deck first, it's because I was hoping I could do it fast enough to unlock ideas and take the last deck. Each idea reduces the deck cost by 2%, so that would be a That's 4%. Actually make it and available about the estates. Actually, no, let's move the capital. Adaptive adaptive combat terrain. This is the reason why I'm moving the capital to hills. In hills, highlands. Or that we're supposed to protect. Let's hope they don't build another one here just to troll me. year 1500 to conquer all the provinces. The Burmese culture group. Provinces. We have most of them. About skill achievement. Being starting as an one province miner. Not only defeat them, but take 60% war score worth of provinces. About developing right about now, might as well take the money. I'm avoiding rebels like the plague, and the game says to me, well, Marco, I'm gonna have to fight some rebels. I'm upset you're not fighting enough rebels. becoming sleepy. What time is it? Oh. We have the idea. The deck. I'm gonna unlock it by September of 1492. To not right now because this is all at very high local autonomy. They the late maintenance and not grab any money from these. Basically, not enough money. Of course, I could have more manpower earlier. Shitty event. More military points, so that's very good. Look, having admin to core all of these. But you need the money. Right, we need to build a fort. More manpower, and I think it's time to pour as much stuff as we can to have more manpower. By Bengal. Right, they're allied with Delhi. Do you have a truce with Ming? They're already a tributary. Anyone else? Maybe this will do it. Maybe it won't be enough. We'll worry about. I can save some ducats and not build a fort here. What else? I need to snipe that for. Army for our nation. Sweet, this is good. To the guys, clergy. Quite happy. Go for a strike, welcome. Good evening. This is not going very well. I would unlocked it already if it wasn't for the bad luck. Maybe this time around we'll do it, I don't know. Cancel the alliance. Expected, you're gonna have trouble coring. You're so dead, Ming. You're so dead. I'm gonna celebrate this. If it wasn't this late, I would make some noise now. Anyway, I need to. I'll be right back, just a couple of minutes. Hello, Warp Kitty. And yeah, this is where I would make a save, you're right. That really qualifies as save scumming. Anyway, it's not difficult to get to this point, so I guess. Not difficult. Anyway, I think we'll make it. I don't need to save here. I mean, it's gonna require some massive amount of bad luck to this event. And not having a fort here. Should be like stack wipe after stack wipe with this event. Cause, this is gonna give me a pretty huge morale advantage over these guys. If we also grab the advisor, and it's time to make some rivals. Letting me rival my allies. I mean, from the five that I can rival, two of them are my allies. Guys rivaled me, so let's return the favor. Let's rival Bahmanis too, whatever. here's hoping these two don't ally each other, but even if they do, they won't have time to gain favors, so they won't attack me. The help of Bahmanis. Bahmanis cannot core my stuff. I mean, they don't have claims, so... doing this for the little edge, not little, very little edge provided by our projection. Little because you know it's just a very little power projection. So let's start ending some embargoes. Sees Pegu again. A shit ton of going away. Sweet, sweet, go. Grab our claim. Not paying for the fort. They didn't build a fort here. Not yet. Auto cab and power. What? I had like 70. Cost me 50. Tell me I have more claims somewhere. Yeah, I do. That event, an event, earlier event. 50. My network points. Single claim. Able to unlock another idea. Land leader maneuver. There we go. Let's see how much development here. Better to core those two. wanting to insult one of these guys at before declaring war on Ming, I'm gonna insult Bahmanis or Delhi so that I can max out my power projection, maximize my power projection. Is malfunctioning. It's giving me good events one after the other. Something's wrong. As usual, as in the last attempt, I'm gonna wait until the last moment for recruiting the mercs. And the forts are online. I'm not protecting myself against Bengal in an attempt to save some money. I hope I don't regret it. Just hope they don't pay for the fort at the last moment. If they do, that's gonna be dreadful. Because I'm not gonna build... Okay, we're capped out in manpower. Because I'm not gonna build... artillery. Just one. Limit of 40. It's gonna go up to 41. So I can build another, say, 29 regiments. For the troops. Prepare to go say hello to them. That's Hate you, Bahmanis. We just need a general. Demand a general from here, we'll have the disaster. The disaster is gonna take my money away. Air admin and military. I need extra morale. Okay, sweet. Level 2 though. Need the general. Me luck. Good. Fuck, that's decent. Alright, let's wait until before things go, just in case things go south. And Ming goes to war. Your stuff. Give me Dali. And declare war without canceling the tributary status, because if I do it, if I don't do it this way, they'll pay for the fort. Won't be able to declare war until 1st of June, so fort will end up with garrison. Just need to protect these two provinces and our own forts, and that's it. We rolled decently well, or at least not dreadfully. We'll grab the war score needed to finish this. I need this pop up. First thing that could happen was to see Stark from Ming arrive here before we take the fort. That was close. Now great power. Really want to use them to attack the fort. Maybe I shouldn't. Plenty of cavalry. We also have plenty. What could happen to us is if they split their troops. Go for my forts. Thousand troops, 40. Afraid of engaging me, keep preparing to do it. Bad, they have their entire army here. They've coordinated well, very well. Extremely well to win against 80,000. My troops behind the forts, they'll try to siege these and they'll try to go for my forts. I don't know, we should have a pretty gigantic morale advantage over them. A bit compensated by their higher prestige. We'll see how this goes. Maybe if I put all the stacks, stack these guys in a single stack, they'll go somewhere else. Kidding me, you're gonna stack 50,000 troops on top of that fort? Your ticket to win this. You're going to do. Going to go around to attack me here. Really looks like that's what you're willing to do or gonna do. Definitely. The rare occasion where the AI is actually playing smartly. Fucked up. Knew what they were gonna do. Why did I stop here? Mercenaries do I have available? It'd have been better for me to defend here. Fast enough. you have no more no less than 1.2 morale advantage. We have a discipline advantage now, which gives us a little bit of a tactics advantage. But we're facing 4-1. And they rolled better. Again, they rolled better. Nothing I can do about this. They keep rolling better. We have actually equal rolls now. And we won. It run away. Oops, didn't suffer as many casualties as I thought I would. Cancel these. Wasting 5 ducats. Not a huge deal. With some luck, these guys will coordination. Say hello to that stack. It's cannons. And the game is being good to me this time around. 20 prestige, so grab a little bit more of morale. No effects. Oh, Shinkasness. More regulars being built up north. Build cavalry. I'm too scared to move away from these provinces, to be honest with you. I know if I stay here, it's gonna be difficult. Our leader just came of age, so this... apparently, that reset the karma. We have 10% discipline. Yeah, this is luck, very luck based. There's no way I could time a leader coming of age. I mean, I could time a war for the leader coming of age, but I cannot set the timer for a dude to die, so that I could come of age at the right moment. What fort? Oh, okay. This dude over here. No problem. Poison. Basically it, with that selection. So that they go elsewhere. Go back. Provinces, some unfortified provinces here. Probably go for it. They're going for them, or are they? No, they're trying to coordinate to attack this tank. I'm too stubborn. Okay, let's get on. To win more battles. Like AI was improved, or it's they have no, I mean, they don't have lots of options, so they can go over there, they can come here, and that's it. I was was bigger, they would probably derp as they usually do, but in less variables, much less variables, they actually play decently. This means we are gonna have another big fight. The resources. No way. Maybe they'll split up. What should hold? Maybe they'll split up and come to this fort or go over there, whatever. And snipe their armies. My armies are out of reach. What will they do? If I want them to come to this fort, I shouldn't be as close. They're derping already, or are they? I want up to catch them at the forts. Again. I want them to go for the fort. Able to win that pretty easily. Okay, they're going for a Ford. Becoming impatient. For the wargon. Wait, they're actually going after the fort. Our opportunity. It's plenty of troops in the vicinity. Not that great of an opportunity. We have to fight them. Now they've received a massive penalty from crossing no, they didn't. They were moving. They were moving, so could have grabbed that penalty, unless it was fixing 1.21. The wargon. Oh, they're derping so hard. They're derping so hard. They're going the other way. Wait for a movement lock on that stack. They'll simply change their... It take a while though. Wait for the movement lock on that stack. Okay, that should be enough. Oh, they're all going the other way. Sweet. Yes. Now they have that crossing. No general. And another one going down the drain. They were coming. Over here. We can actually do this and maybe win. The terrain penalty is cancelled by... our capital bonus. Okay, I need a cup of water. I'm gonna risk it. Managed to win this quickly enough against snipe that army. One advantage. We'll have a crossing penalty. We have advantage in morale. We have advantage in discipline. We have advantage in tactics, slightly. Uh-oh. They've... kill these guys quickly. Come on. There we go. I told you we would see stack wipe after stack wipe. Press this first. And this might be another one. What I mean? His early advantage in morale is devastating. The big power now. There we go. Plus 40 from battles. That combined with the ticking war score will allow us to take these provinces. Need the war score to reach nearly 60. It depends on their war enthusiasm. Ladies. It's cheaper to consolidate and recruit new troops and to reinforce them. Oh, say hello to those cannons. Nope. Sit tight. Maximum war score from battles already. We just need to defend these. Say hello to those thugs. Point waiting for more to arrive. Escape. hold a zero. Another 13 stock coming this way. What happens when we get too confident? Got troops over here, I was not seeing them. The point of this is to prevent them from finding troops again. Big stacks. Rebuild. Protect the Wargo. Giving access to me. Suffered some defeats and was at medium enthusiasm. Back to high enthusiasm. Weaker now. Cavalry, just six cavalry. Altered. I mean, we don't fight like with 2 to 1 odds or similar, it should be fine. Gonna have a tactics penalty. Pass. Of course, I can attack with both stacks. Then I'll do it. The other ones are they're closer than what I thought. These are locked, unfortunately. Those are gonna have a tactics penalty, but we need to kill them pretty quickly. And we did. For another movement lock. E vamos. War score, they don't need enthusiasm. Not enough, but check. I need is something similar to this. I'm gonna be very upset if to core the provinces. I think I only need to occupy them, own them. I won't have enough admin to core it. Okay, they're derping again. Or are they? If they are. And movement lock. So. To get away, but not all of them will make it. Okay, they suffer a massive penalty if they do. Yep. Crossing penalty on top of everything. Nope. Not this time. I think at this point, if we had artillery, we could go on the offensive. Yeah, let's siege some stuff. Not get taken by the forts. Imagine again doing this at very hard difficulty. The Ming would have an extra 50 stack. So earlier, they would have another 50 stack. Continue this, I would definitely take the interest per annum, minus one. That's gonna reduce the morale of my armies. Not gonna continue this, it's just... Damn it. it's just to grab these provinces and unlock the achievement, and that's about it. I think we're almost there. One with the AI to take the unfortified provinces. The ones not in range of the forts. Gives a little war score, but it's staying still. Being still. Hiding now. Eight. Okay, let's actually see the provinces. Not the one with the fort. Screw up. Minus two. These provinces. Another month. Beginning of next month. Might be possible. Other dudes inside. What now? Okay, I'm gonna save the game here because I'm very tired. Up with this, I don't think I did, but it's definitely possible. I've saved the game to redo the pistol if I screw up. No achievement. I need to core this stuff. Either that or I screwed up with the pistol. Yep, this stuff needs to be cored. 18 months to record this stuff. You'll be fine. Wait for the war exhaustion to go down. Achievements don't trigger at the end of the month, they trigger the next day. Get rid of the mercenaries. Get rid of the mercenaries. Bengal will attack. Can't get rid of this guy. So annoyed if I make any mistake. Oh shit. There's this province here. Luckily, I made a save. I didn't see there was a province belonging to Tibet that we need to take. It's very late, it's 5 a.m. I'm very tired, I just want to finish this, wrap this up. Rain X down, it was asking. Ming has access through all tributaries. Nope. Yes, you're right. Just role playing. I know you've said it a while ago, but focus on the game. Can't I keep the bloody map mode? Okay. Going, boys. Okay, they're willing to concede defeat. I mean, not concede defeat, give me what I want. For me, I'm gonna have to deal with these rebels. Take this province too. It's just another month. Do they have? Five loans. Let's double check again that I'm very tired. Okay, I mean. Doesn't, because we need to call them all. Yep, the achievement fired. So the first Tongu Empire, we unlocked it. I'm gonna show it to you. So that's it for today's stream. Now, with on very hard, says Rajorn. Sure. I mean, it can be done. After what we saw here at normal, with enough luck, it can be done. But I want to play something else. Anyway, thanks for the compliments. Playing X down. And yeah, that's it for today's stream. I'm gonna go straight to bed. Thanks for joining me, keeping me company, and I hope you enjoyed the stream. And I hope to see you soon. Take care.